And we're back. We're going to go with the silicoids first. They explore the new world. Let's see if there's anything interesting here. Okay, this one we must take note of. Honor. Oh lord, the second has got green conditions of subsistence fertility, not so great, but still 60k size, that's the good stuff, minus 1 gravity. Okay. Other than that, what the shipyard tells me, I have to put my ship in reserves, not enough. Okay, that was it. Colony ships going to our star scene. Take 4 more turns to get there. Let's see, technology wise, I am starting to get to the terraforming tech. It also gives me a pollution improvement. Maybe that's why, that explains why with less industry they can get more production and not that much more gold. It could be because of their pollution reduction skins. We can check that homeworld versus homeworld again to see how they're doing at this stage. Production cost, I'm injecting 2000 AUs and I'm paying 500 for pollution. This one it's injecting just 1k AU and it's paying more for pollution. Yeah, it's no contest. If I were to mess with this setting and bring it up to 2k AU, this pollution would skyrocket. Yeah, that's one of the saving graces of the silicoids. They don't have many saving graces, but they do have a few. So it is time to check the planets again. I would check migration bubbles because I cannot really check them otherwise. No way, not enough population spreading as occurred for me to be able to set the migration here. This world's probably not even worth bothering to check. And we have Proxima, which it's beginning to climb in its power. Because this is the magnet world. It's beginning to finish some of industries. Do this world still require population injection? Can't be hurt by it, but at the same time, and this one definitely needs it. Okay. Check the worlds now. 4 turns. Why are you doing this to me? Why do you keep lying to me? Spaceport. Did you manage to finish at least 1 spaceport? No. Feng Pu. Six. We can overdrive because our pollution tolerance is solid, but still. The remaining money I could dry science, and if I move here, then there is danger. Danger of not enough population. Actually, this one does have a bit of population. Tomate in huge trouble with population limit. That's why I slowed it down. Huge issues with the lack of population. Proxima. Here I must be very careful microing this world. Must be very careful. Research is important, but I don't want you to get broke. The last hug defense needs to happen. Government there, the last industry will get the population it's holding. The 9 population units are holding. Groovy. You need to prepare yourself to flood colony ships. A lot of worlds that these guys like in my near neighborhood. System colony in Pisignia, I'm willing to drop 6 colony ships at once. But this one, oh, I know, I remember this one. It's pretty bad. Pretty bad at what it does. I could accelerate that, but the colony ships won't be ready, so we will not do that. 4 turns is good enough. This one I already microed at the end of the previous episode. And that is that. We end the turn. Construction of colony ship. Yes. Industry there, research there, deep extractive mining, hog defense in Proxima, government there, exploration, migration to my temple, migration colonies. Let's check this this gov world. Doesn't, is it any good? Well then. Let's write this down and make a note for it. Okay, the third 78 capability minus 1 gravity. Yeah, might send to you. Where exactly are you located though? Let's zoom a bit. Okay. Let's do this. Coming from Tarsim. So the Gemma, the Gemma Starship mobilization center could work, could be used for this, yeah. And I think I'm going to use it, yeah. Shipyard and just sending people to Tarsim. Yeah. Lot of people to Tarsim, actually. I could be sending only 3 ships, but no. Need to get the Gemma mobilization center first up. Nothing else happened, huh? Nothing much happened. Shipyards. One of those planets it's building some system colony. This one, I need to be careful not to lose it. Good. Let's see. 3 turns. Turns and some leftover science. If I try to do this, it's gonna. Come on, you stupid spaceports. Make yourself. Whip yourself into existence. Or something. Here we have. Feng Pu. The world of. Almost complete gas. Oh no, it's not building system colony ships. The other one is, and it's going to take forever. Yeah. I remember now. Here, the world to pay maximum attention to what are you doing, world. Government will be done. Industry will be done next turn. We'll be ready. Ready. For capacity mine. Okay, put some in there soon. Colony, more colony ships. This is the one that's really struggling. Really struggling here. I can put a lot of money in that, but what's the point? Without the test tubes, the money is useless, so let's save the money. I can put test tubes and try to do this. Oof. We went too far. Okay, 2% is not a lot of hammer going this way, but yeah. Toliman A managed to finish the first industry. Yay! Yay. Which means he's going to finish a ton of bioharvesting fast. Silicoid bioharvesting bullshit. Hug defense, hug defense, hug defense, la Serta. Oh. La Serta, with all these people, it will finish the industry there, but the point is, yeah, it takes at least 2 turns to build them. So, there's always that. And now we have hammers to start working on that thing. I think that is the whole point of this. Let's not waste money on 6 tubes. Let's try to do something here. Industry. I still want that industry done in one turn. Yeah, and with the surplus you can put some on security, system security. Eta Sifi. Could finish this turn, I know. Yeah. Am I going broke? Not quite yet. So we're going to end turn again. Wow, we have the first spaceport. More colonies, exploration, 3 systems exploration, a bit of migration. One. Some industry there, industry base goes up, yeah. Research still suffers. Okay, let's play the bugs for 2 turns now. Spaceport, shell, industry, new colonist, wow, no. A new exploration reserves, we have a recon ship which I should drop. Colony ships, none of them made anywhere. So let's drop the recon ship and send it someplace where no one else has gone before. I don't know. It's hard to tell at this point. Very hard to tell at this point. Where no one else has gone before, that is. Budget is holding. Put more money into the research. Colony ship. And also the spaceports are going up at the decent pace, which is amazing. Yeah. Do they add to this GDP total? I hope they are. Could we try to check it next turn, because not much is going to change here. Not much should be changing next turn. So I could write it down to some corner of paper. 11. Seven. 15 GDP. See how that changes next time. Or in a second, yeah, this sys colony ship probably a waste of resources putting bugs in a optimal surfaces, but we'll have to live with it right now. Actually, the second more colony pods. Actually, the seventh. What do you know? More colony pods. Actually, the third. Can we have more colony, please? Needs more cowbell loony. Finished worlds. Who's this one? Oh, nice. Food wise, am I going towards a crisis of some sort? Or some food crisis? Okay. Let us hope not. Yeah, also system planet grants will go to this to those crappy worlds that I probably shouldn't have settled this early instead of those system colony ships. I could have been building real colony ships and drop them to send them to some really hospitable planets where the bugs would have been more useful. But yeah, live and learn. Oopsie. Oopsie. Okay. The Zhadran Zardan. Let's write it on the proper paper. The second it's green. I need okay and village. But with gravity issues. This is, though, however, the big news. The fourth one is got a trading race. If I can get to trade these guys with the spaceports of my over my solar capital system, which is going to be full of spaceports. Things are going to be interesting. Yellow one. That's all you need to know. Very rich magnet. You need to activate those guys. Though, if I do activate them, then I won't be able to use migration quite as liberally as before, but I think I will survive. And there's also green too here, which we will get later. 23K. Okay, what else did you explore? Because we did explore a lot. Slint. This is yellow 2, yellow 1, yellow 2, smallish. Varinia. Big Red Worlds and the eye. As opposed to small Red Worlds. Good. Colony is up. Probably only one. And planets. Let's go to Urna and drop those guys here. System colony completed. Then I have only one colony ship in reserves. If I want to activate the Nolams immediately, I'll need to. I'll wait for one more. But the Recon I can send someplace. Or it will probably never reach. Okay, it will reach. Good. Good. Finances are holding. Planet wise. Let's see. Special 5, 11,870, and their productivity from population went down. That's something to take note of. And it went to 129% from 140. It seems to have gone up, like almost 200, like almost 200. But oh, the trade thing light lit up, which means they're trading with spaceports in the same system. I'm certain they're not doing jumps. You have to jump to a mount, and that doesn't even have a spaceport yet. So they're trading amongst themselves. Now what you're telling me here? So you have trading income 409, 85 trading income, 0, 178. So without any upgrade, those trade posts are trading in the same system. That's what's happening. Good. Need to know. Special. But then, if this 178 trade value is fresh, then that's what happened. That's how the That is on top of the GDP, though. Don't mess it up. The GDP is GDP. The GDP increased also, and also the tax from trade. Could this be it? The spaceport actually do add a bit to GDP, but a lot more to the system trade, because the GDP, it's only you get only a tiny bit of GDP. This one adds directly. Could be. Urna the second. It's also building its own spaceport, but it's got no other planets in the same system with spaceports up to trade with. So there's that. Also, the population is smaller. Light colony. Light cruiser colony. What are you still building? Spaceport. So good. This one colonies, yeah, it has a trade post, spaceports, and they are probably trading with the capital. That's what's happening. Again, another planet with spaceports. One spaceport. We might try to get them done in a reasonable amount of time. Yeah. Maybe I overdid it here. Probably, but Heschel the third has got no spaceports whatsoever. Soil enrichment industry there. Like finally the final there, it's going to activate in You're not going to run out of population, are you? No spaceports operational. Now you're still building the dais are up, all the dais are up. Amazing feat of engineering. But you're also going to require even more capacity for those deep extraction mines. Herschel the fourth. Colony, 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 colony. Yes, we do want more of those. Please send some more of those. Special one. More colony, if you please. If you please. Azor, it's up to two industry dais. The gravity is fighting us here on this world. But we can get even more industry. And what about the money? The mineral. Yeah, these guys can afford. Aren't the automated factories yet? Oh. Bye bye. Whatever. Silicoids. Bye bye. I'm going bye bye. Planets, come on. I'm on four again. Bad gravity, endorphin. Soon, Shira Sun Ish. Sun I have a colony ship, but I want to send two to make certain I get the golems, nolems ASAP. Okay. Not this. I want to go and do this. And set a bit of migration to this colony as well. This poor colony, which is probably going to struggle a lot, just like the other one. On the left, I shouldn't have bothered. But it is very rich. Very richness. Shipyards, we have three colony ships. I don't need three colony ships to send there. We get attack. In the sun. Two colony ships. Close this screen. Two colony ships should do. For the Gnolan world, but okay. So it's not even that far. It's this one here, right? Yeah. Two colony ships. Now the question is, there's no question about it, deploy task force. Colony squadron, two colony ships. These colony ships go to activate Zadran. That is their goal. Again, I'm left with one colony ship. Should I send it as it is, or should I wait for another to start sending two colonies? I think at this point the Empire of the Bug can afford to send at least two colony pods per target. I think it's the least I could do. Eta Crucis. What's in Eta Crucis? Nothing good. Wow. So let's go to the planet side. Yeah, all these tiny planets require population. Though the Wurna ones are kinda misplaced, I think. So colony ship and spaceports. Another spaceport around the corner. Marvelous. And the GDP, it's hovering. I don't think another spaceport finished this time, so the GDP is hovering, which is extremely nice to see. Okay. Yeah, almost no change to the GDP, and it's still 139% productivity from population. I'm really curious next turn if the GDP jumps and by how much. That would be what the latest spaceport added. We have a ton of extra money. There is no grant. Where is all this extra money coming from? No, not research. Research is okay. Could put it here, but okay, let us save up a bit. Spaceports, you need to focus more on your spaceports. Not really, you have no other planet in system to trade with. So let the spaceports cook slow. But really pushing research wherever you can. Colony. More colony ship. Oh, you're like not building anything else anymore? Probably not enough population for a spaceport. Ooh. A lot of money is being saved this way. We can put here. Kind of expensive, but maybe the population will grow and will cover. I will cover the debt. Deep extraction, hydroponics. Yeah. Oh, the deep extractions are almost completed. Nice. Nice one. World. Whatever this world is, it's doing fine by me. Special the third. Such a building, dude. Soil enrichment. Nice. And hydroponics. Yeah, way to stay ahead. All theirs have been completed. Thank God. The capacity upgrades have been done. Deep extraction mining. Unfortunately, automatic mines are going to hit. Ooh. Speaking of automated mines. Speaking of those automated mines, I don't have that much of a mineral edge. Yeah. All that is completed, and now the capacity is going to start to sap even more into the amount of population for this planet required for this planet to run. Shell 4, Azor 2. Oh, we have extra money here. How's that possible? Okay. Okay. Amount of population it's holding for this second, but it's probably going to be fleeting very soon. Special one. Ooh. The Struggles of Fashion One. Amount 5. I'm doing some research in the asthma. Actually, we're kind of running out of things to build on this not so rich world. If I build more industry, those automatic factories are gonna suffer. I'm consuming too much mineral. Mineral crisis incoming. Bug mineral crisis incoming. It's already 3 research station for this world that doesn't make money. Bioharvest it then. And there. Point bioharvesting. Ah, put military on that planet. Okay. Shira. In the world, you need to get your production sorted out. Same for you. Same for you. And this could finish this turn if it really wanted to. The industry. I know you can. I just want to. Need to want it as well. Focus. We have a colony ship that made it someplace. Which one? Papers, what do you say about Indusan? Should be a colony on its way to Indusan. Where did we write this down? Did we actually write this down? Someplace. Any place. Yeah, actually did. The fourth world, it says. Okay. Fourth world it is. Forces colonize. Shipyard. Talk to me, shipyard. Good. Rigel Kent. Didn't I explore this already? Maybe I explored it and forgot about it or something? I don't see it written down anywhere though. So let's... Rigel Kent. First on yellow 2. 64k minus 2g. Second one, it's green, but it's small and has poor gravity. Third one, it's green, it's bigger and no gravity penalty. Fourth one, yellow. 85k, holy crap. Another yellow, 2. 20k. Okay. What else? That is about it. I think I did check the planets, right? I think it was the thing. Last thing I did. So we can go one turn. Futuristic turns, yes. Ooh, Meklon. It's red too, so I would need a lot of colony ships to activate these guys, but these guys would be relevant if I were to have to invade worlds. But also they're relevant because they like red planets compared to what I can. It'll be quite a while, quite a long while until I'll be able to terraform. So Meklon, but I'll need to send like 3 or 4 colony ships to activate them, which I will. Meklon 4, green 1. Very rich, 32k minus 1g, but what is more important is red 2, magnet. Doesn't even matter what type of magnet it is, we need to send something here. And I have also Vidar 90k size sweet spot, which I also need to take. Automatic factories will be done soon. Spaceport Heschel 5. This is something that interests me greatly. Economics. So, the GDP. What happened to the GDP? Unfortunately, the occupation from population went down 138, but the GDP went down 1163. Why? What happened to those money figures that they show here on Spaceport? Maybe, like with many other structures, it takes an additional turn for the spaceport to activate and to start producing. That's the case with a lot of structures. I'm going to put it to the test. I'm going to go one more turn and see what happens. Hopefully I don't forget what happens with this. I'm filled with spaceports to the brim. Yeah. No more spaceports for you. Give me all my money so I can build colony ships faster. Or I could try to up the materials processor, but there's no ship I need to build. A bigger ship I need to build. Actually, what I could do is I could try to fiddle with 5x module, yeah, for efficiency. Let's see how much production points this world can master. Construction. How many colony ships I have? Only 2. I'll need to send more Tau Hydra. We sent someone here. Why? Why did we do such a thing? And which is the candidate one? Probably the fourth one. Notes. Where are you? Tau Hydra. Yeah, the fourth world. Let us cross it off the list. Let us drop the colony. Anyone else? Reconnaissance mon. It didn't work. Again. Reconnaissance mon. Anything good? Doesn't look like it. No. Shipyards. Anyone else sleeping in its boots? Meklon. Don't just stand there. Do something. New planet in the sun. New colonists. New colonists. Adequate. So what is actually happening now? I am having a bit too many new worlds. Food, bioharvesting issues, and I need to slow down. The automatic factories are also going to kick in. I need to slow down and think what's gonna happen here. Technology wise, automatic factories are going to activate next turn. Fulcrus mining, it's still quite a way. It's not going to save the day that quickly. So Herschel, from next turn on, before that, Indusan will need migration, of course, as a new world. Amount 4, we'll have to check. How badly do you still need population? Come on, close this. How badly do you still need the population? Productivity from population high. But once all this crap comes online, not be so high. But you'll have to figure it out on your own. You are a green world. Let's see what's the growth factor here. Haha. Marvelous. You are on your own. I'm on 5. Azor. This one again. We need population, but soon. It's quite big. Quite big. Maybe we focus on food generation on this planet. Wow, so much industry. So much industry. I think player defined 3 was my food template. Empire. Yeah, 3. Good. You would need more population, but you are growing insanely fast by yourself. That's why I picked you. So, as much as it would help, because right now it's growing 400 a turn. But if I had it here, it's 30 people on this planet, it would probably grow. Triple that, not triple, but double at least. But for now, we need to stop migrating there. It needs to make it on its own. Okay, so the colony ship will end, and then with the automatic factories operational, hopefully be able to do times 5 colony ships. Colony, 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 colony. Very rich world. Mr. Very rich world. 125% of the productivity from populations on this world. It's really, really helping me with extraction mining. That is very nice of it. Let's see how it grows. It grows very well. Heschel 7. Wow, it is completed. Soil enrichment and also the food issue. Technology, technology, food. Food! Automatic biocare. I mean, full crust mining is going to help me deal with the bigger issue, the mineral issue is going to be the bigger issue. But also this, if I activate Gnolams and Reas, those guys will need food as well. Food, I need to go to manually go through all planets and prioritize food on some of them, if I can. I need to keep focusing on the full crust mining here. Even so, it's going to be late and there's going to be issues. Mining and food, danger. Danger, danger, the dangers of overexpanding are finally catching up with us. So, enrichment, hydroponic, yes, hydroponic plants. Every bit of food will help. Every tiny bit of food will help. Which planet were we? This one. Hydroponics, lovely. And it is rich and the mountains are also it's filled. It has a decent amount of filling. There's one more deep extraction on this one, which is not going to add a whole lot minerals. This world, Heschel 3rd, soil enrichment, yes, he is aware of the incoming food crisis. Deep extraction everywhere. It's a rich world. As it increases, it will increase the amount of minerals it produces, but also the amount of minerals it consumes. Not going to be wow. Rich. 64% of this world, if I keep sending people in it, it's going to increase dramatically the amount of minerals it generates. Yeah. Heschel 8. You need migration. You need migration for us to output more mineral. Yeah, you're already pretty filled. Migration wouldn't help here. Who else is spitting out a ton of mineral? This one. It's again pretty filled and deep extraction is in place. Azor. It is a poor world. It is a poor world and what it's trying to do, it's trying to build even more industry, which is going to eat more and more minerals. Please do the bioharvest and then the soil enrichment. Please do so. It's not gonna listen to me though. And I'll just have to cut funding here. I know I'll have to. Heschel. No food output, just a tiny bit of mineral, which means it's a poor planet, yeah. No increase of mineral output in the future from there. Same here, unfortunately. And this is a rich world, but it has no hills. Ammo 3. More and more industry. Why? Why you? Of course, consuming minerals fuels economy, but not when you don't have minerals to spare. That's when things get complicated. And yeah, all those worlds are about. Try to make some food, dude. Food. Shira. Oh boy. Oh boy. Bioharvest. Change it. Change it to bioharvest. I need some very tight monitoring. Arable bioharvest. Try to get those bioharvesters up. It is a rich world and it also got some mines. It's not very rich though, so these things shouldn't be really mined, but I might have no choice. At least until the crisis passes, I probably have to mine. And send people to this planet, though, the gravity penalty, it's not gonna help. You. At least you're rich. Try to get the mines running. Try to get the mines running. Try not to get, not to run out of money until you complete your first, assignment. This one's very rich, yeah, and I said mine. Mine as much as you can. Welcome to the Empire in the Sun. Another poor world. God damn it! God damn it. A mobilization center will be a factor sometime. The problem is it's so stringent, we'll have to resort to some very inefficient mining here. Very inefficient mining. Mine this stupid world. We're desperate. We are desperate. We are becoming minerally dis desperate. I should have become minerally desperate a bit earlier. And also food-wise. Food-wise, things are not so great either. Shipyards, anything else in order? Reserves one colony ship. So we hit enter again and we check again the GDP on that spaceport thingy. Automatic factories. Oh, this is gonna hurt. This is gonna hurt, and the food situation—it's galloping. Automatic deep extraction mining, soil enrichment, Tukitian, the planet is being colonized. Yeah, before we do anything else, actual GDP 137% from population. GDP keeps going down. Yeah, at least if this their productivity from population would stay there, maybe the spaceport is adding one gold and this dropping 1%. It's dropping like a few hundreds, and that's why I can't see it here. But even if so, that means they're essentially useless. This planet at 137 productivity. Once I let those automatic factories run wild, once I set them loose on this world, they're gonna consume a ton of minerals. So maybe it's not a terrible thing. Wow, and she's gonna do it in one turn. Oi, 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 oi. There's only two industry days here. Yes. Things are going to hurt massively. Massive hurt. Massive heartache on its way for these guys. Shipyards. Reserves. I have four cruiser colony. I'm going to send them all to the Rea world, which is Meklon, which is, where the hell is that Rea world? Here. Deploy task force. A squadron of colony ships. All four accept to Meklon. One go to Meklon. 12 turns. And why I did this is because I want the options these worlds provide to colonize different rich worlds, basically. Like you've seen, minerals are going to be a problem. Also, those being homeworlds, they might have ability to produce a bit of farming. A bit of farming. Because food colony pigeon, holy crap! All those colonists that I'm dropping are going to ask food. Please give us food, feed us. Need to take more serious the food situation. Way more seriously. Damn. TMO, very poor green too. This one needs to be written down because it is so much significant. Yeah, TM1, TM1 green too. 43k. G problem. Slight G problem. Construction of colony ships and Kentucky. Cutting, okay. Have anything good for me, Mr. Kentucky? Not really. Not really. Okay. Yeah, and with this double huge crisis looming in the near future, this is the solution to this, to automatic factories. And biologically speaking, the automatic bunker should be the solution to food, but we should also take care to build to prioritize those types of DAS more in the meantime to delay the crisis and give myself time. But let's see how these guys are doing. These guys don't have food slash mineral crisis in view, in the immediate view, because that is simply because they lack the technology. They will not get automated factories ever. So I decided to try to go some other direction with them. The alternative would have been smart drugs in case they get them. I don't even know if they do. Yeah. Sunlight terraformation technology. Shipyards, what happened? Reserves, I have 4 colony ships in reserve. Not bad. Not bad. We explored some new worlds, huh? The world in the mirror. Not interesting. What other worlds did we explore? Hyades. Oh, that's pretty close. That would be that would be some major ass fail scouting right there. Hyades. One. Important notice. Sweet spot. Rich sweet spot. 42k value. Minus 1 gravity. Then we have a green one, which is very rich. And it's got 29k and 1g penalty. Green 2 with terrible gravity, but then we have a green 2 with 40k population capability and gravity issues. So yes, Hyades, this Hyades world. There was something more with Glaconda, I think, which was close, but maybe I'm going to use a system shift there because, simply because I don't seem to have enough. Simply because I do not have enough. 60k color second, 60k, but this one is a sweet spot. That's Komahanko, 60k, G1, Rigel Kent. Yeah. Again, need to slow down and think about my options here. Science wise, we need to be careful. Kaif, Kaf. Olor. Not the best. Not the best, not the best. Migration, few numbers as usual. Industry, industry, bioharvest, industry, industry. Mm-hmm. Spaceport and Frankpaw. Shipyards, I only have some colonies directed towards Tarsin. I have these 4 guys. Do I send them right now or do I wait? 4 guys, it's a bit on the low side. I figured I send at least 6 at once. Let's see what the planets are doing. So the way things are working here. This one, I would love to set migration, but it's still not filled with circuit all regions, so I cannot do that because of the magnet races. Other than that, this guy is kind of the same story. So I keep loading up Fengpu and Tome. Feng. Military. Colony. For 5. And 5. Yeah, he's slowly adding spaceports that apparently do nothing. The useless spaceports. Oh no. We need you to finish in 2 turns. Finish in 2 turns, please. And no money from trade. Receiving money from grants to the homeworld. The poor homeworld. Fengpu. What you doing, Fengpu? You're saving money. That is lovely. Deep extraction of the mine. The last of the thing, it's completed. The last there. We can work it. The deep extraction. Incredible. Tome. Colony systems. Colony. Proxima. Oh, we know it, who Proxima is. Proxima is the, yeah, deep extraction spaceport. So it still has decently good productivity from population. What I need from it now is to keep spitting colony ships. We need the colony ships from these guys. Okay. Minimize this and add mobilizations. Proxima mobilization. Think is very close to another world. I can do with that, but 3 turns a bit too long. We'll put some points into mobilization center until it realizes it will have those structures out. Up for colony construction. Fengpu, 93% village deep extraction mining government there. Wow, this is still out of on this average world, I put a mine on broken terrain. Why? Probably was desperate. There was some mineral crisis or such that I resorted to such desperate measure. Pi Cygni. System. Oh, I know you. I know you. The sock. Trying to build something that you'll never be able to build. That's basically what you're doing. Gemma, in 2 turns, Gemma will give me mobilization center. Hack defense, who is this Lacerta? Why bring this? Why are you bringing this? Government there, why? Toyman, so this is where the food is being built, but yeah, they like to farm mountains. It is true. They really like to farm mountains. Amazing. You better believe it. Shipyards. If I'm waiting, I'm waiting 2 more turns. Where would I want to send those worlds to? Where would I want to send those worlds? Those colony ships, it doesn't matter because I want to send more. I wouldn't send only 4. I will not send only 4. We will send more. So we're going to turn 49. Deep extraction mining, government basic. Mineral station somewhat under ropes. Also the mass synthesizer, it's sinnable, but this is going to take a lot more than this. Way more than this to unlock. But we have sunlight redirection. In 6 turns we'll be able to start terraforming some worlds. What else do we want, boss? We really want science. Try again. Try to get some science. Shipyards. Reserves, we have 5 colony ships. Do we send 5? Do we send 5? Do we wait 1 more turn? 1 more turn! Rainbow. There is no break with this world. No break. This one. Deep extraction mining. Tomorrow. All this industry I'm going to unlock here is going to do me more harm than good. More harm than good. It's going to lower the amount of minerals firstly by consuming them and then by lowering the amount of to this stop. I shouldn't put too much in research because there is no base. Spaceport, deep mining, okay, this one will increase a bit the mineral reserve. Fengpu of the colony ships. What, there's nothing cooking? Okay, the government there. And more industry and more crop, but it's not so cool. That's not so cool again. Too low, save some money. Put in research, I think this world can take it. It's got 3 research there. This world could eat those money, yep. Stupidest world. It's never gonna get it done. 1 research there in progress. Gemma, 1 turn. Good. Acerta. It's a great thing you finished the government. It's going to help tremendously. Not. Tuliman, the food factory of the universe. Come on, start checking those. Good. And pull shipyards. Okay, it is decided, we'll wait. Boom. Forest reduced. Colony of Ajadar at FAD 3. The Ajadars don't really like. They might like red worlds for me, I don't know. Let's see. This is the proper. FAD 3. It is yellow too, so it's pretty bad for me with low gravity. Yeah, these guys can be useful. These guys can be useful. Let's pick them up. FAD 3. We have magnet rays of yellow too, so we need to send. I think 3 colony ships should do enough. 3 colony ships should go towards FAD 3. Wherever this world is. That's a bit. It's a green one poor. Okay, Mr. FAD. Where exactly are you, Mr. FAD? Okay. Royal Task Force, Colony, Squadron. 1, 2, 3. Accept. These guys are going to FAD. Are going to fade out of existence. Okay. It's too bad those brightheads are fading out of existence. They're establishing all sorts of short-lived colonies and then disappear, which is not cool. Hyades, where is Hyades? Where is Hyades? It's not there. Null. Mr. Null system. Any good? Not quite. Null system, but where is Hyades? It is very annoying that I cannot see. Very annoying to me. It's not there. What the hell? There. Tommy, deploy task force. How many do you have? 7? We'll take them. We'll take them all. To Hyades, please. Oh, so slow. So slow. So Hyades, the sweet spot, received a ship of 7. And Fad also received a ship of 3. And again, we are out of ships to send, which is not so great. Gnoll, Cuphig. Maybe Cuphig is even better than Hades. Not the right color. Green 2. Terrible gravity. Not quite of the right color. Tome, more people. Okay. Colony deep extraction, colony Pisigny. And here's where the fun begins with this guy. Because that's all the industry she's gonna get. Of course, it's all this extraction mining finishes. He's going to get a bit more money to try to drive them harder, but and he does have. A reason to try to pay this stuff, because there's two of those. Keeps trying developing. Yeah, it's gonna be hard. Pisigny. Good. Mobilization center and Gemma 2 already used it. Space environment module and Proxima spaceport. Shipyards. Okay, the colonies of Tassin. It's about to happen. What do we have here? Tassin, the sweet spot is probably the target. Tassin 4 forces. Land your 8 guys in Tassin. Tassin! We have achieved landing. Interesting. Shipyards, anything else? Colony Fad will take forever. Hyades forever. Plus, it will take forever to build some more colony ships, planets. Let's go through the planets again. Beloved planets. Yes. Who is this? This is the home world. Producing or 5 colony ship projects. And still struggling to finish its spaceports. It's either the spaceports or this. If I cut spaceport production, this could be. And it really isn't. That would almost be one turn per colony ship, but the exception that it isn't quite. And I don't know if I can sustain this, because I'm not growing. The little growth I have, it's eaten away by immigration, required to fill the other stupid worlds that are not growing. Okay. It's kind of a significant loss. Cutting the science, it's not good. 300 per turn. If I lose 300 per turn, it's not 300, it's 250. 6 or 250. I might be able to survive this batch. Maybe. Oh, and there's grants. Oh. Yeah, this is where opening the military valve grant might make sense. I need a bit of help with these colony ships, but I don't know where that money would go. Might go some completely useless shit. These guys. So I'm afraid to do that. Very rich productivity from population. Shitty. You do have the money to do this. So you should also do this. And this is what savings are for. You get the deep extraction mining. Even if we did on that, because you are still receiving more population. You are receiving help. Also receiving some help. Proxima, and here's the deal with Proxima. Normally by now I should have been able to start building colonies. The problem is the game takes a while to register that. Deep core mining, good deep extraction. Thank you. Colony ships. And we stopped it from building anything else. Okay, Signy. Oh, I know this guy. He needs to get broke soon. Ways to get broke soon. Lacerta. Good. Gemma. Gemma finished the mobilization center, which means it could. Let's look at the population productivity. We could prepare to build colony ships. Do you want system colony? You might still need to do this. And add another high defense here. How's the Gemma system? Gemma system, how are you? Red. Stupid yellow, no, we don't care about colonies, local colonies in the Gemma system. What I do care about is this crap. Why waste the buy ads? They grow so slowly, stop wasting them. Same about this Rigel B. Only 9 of them, so they're dying off. Why'd you go there in the first place if you're dying off like that? Why'd you go and do that? Something stupid like that. If you're not going to auto-colonize for me, what good are you for then? Okay. Back to planets, Gemma. Tasifi. Yeah. Gov mining. Rich world. Try to get some more mines up. Never know when the food crisis will strike. This one is Toleman A. The food world. We're going to do so much food. One's gonna wanna eat. Feng Pu, the fifth, yeah. And that takes us to turn 51, and I'm going to take the bugs to turn 51 and end the episode. Do-do-do-do! We dropped a colony to Tarsin 5. And it's got a population of 9. Yeah. Yeah, baby. Could get a very quick mobilization center with the nine guys there. And one thing to keep in mind is, let's hide this. Tarsin is all the way here. I do have some colony ships on its way, yeah. But I don't think. Yeah. I could have made it in time. Yeah, the mobilization center is not gonna happen that quickly. It takes minimum another turn for this to actually activate. Then it takes 2 turns for an industry there to complete. And then with that first industry there, because the moderate gravity, things are not going to go that incredibly quickly. But we know we'll want this, and we'll want some probably want the mobilization center very, very early though, as fast as possible, because there are some good worlds in that direction. This is a rich world, that is bad because it shows it could have been farmed to some extent, but no such luck for this world. Lots of mountains to mine to our heart's content. Leaves room for a bit of industry. A bit more industry, the government there. And a tiny bit of research. Let's have to research this. Okay, so that's how Tarsin will be. And it doesn't require population injection, because we just dropped a ton of population there. Silicoid style. Planets. We shouldn't check this. Let's leave it like this. I said turn 51, not turn 52. Spaceport, colony ships. How many colony ships do I have? In reserves, only 2. Recon Suji Tarsin. Yeah. Whatever. That those are the stats for these guys. They are holding on. Surprisingly, they are holding on to the bugs. A bit behind science-wise. Maybe I made a misplace with the bugs. The bugs, however, are very, very worrisome. They are about to hit to simultaneous crisis. Food, both food and mineral. Those are the usual consequences of overexpanding. But, okay. Not good. And damn. Hey, what did I do here? I remember Tiamo checking out this world. Yeah. Did I write this down? Yeah, it is kind of an interesting world for the bugs. Yeah, Tiam, green 240, okay. What the hell am I doing here? Industry there, new colonist. Automatic factories, Tau Hydra, 24%. So this I didn't do. Hog defense, Tau Hydra, mobilization center probably will want to rush. And then take care of pirates, the police. It is a rich world. It is a small world. Small world, huh? Takidi, Takidi. Bioharvest. So it's going to start with a bioharvest. This world. That doesn't bode well. Remove this item. Add bioharvest to region, but please start building the industry first. Government and research. Chup 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 chup. Okay. Planets. We do need migration here. To get that mobilization center up. Shipyards. Jupin. Yes, I already asked them to come down. Okay. Go through each planet. Set the orders and end the episode. 4 turns for a colony? This is not the main planet. For a single colony, yeah. That would have been ridiculously disappointing. Okay. This is the main colony. Yeah, the other world. Other guys are getting this in 6 turns. What about you? Well, this is the best we can do, boss. Unless we cut on automated factories. No. No, 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 no. The automatic factories are the highest priority. Slow down. Get me the automatic factories in 1 turn each. And then we talk. Okay, save some money. You're gonna need it. Get those automatic factories. Get them. This is annoying. Okay. Okay. Once the automatic factories are up, things are going to pick up Here, spaceport, spaceport. You need to be careful not to have player one defined in too many places. That would mean high priority on automated factories, and I don't. Not certain I want to do that all over the place yet. No, sir, I do not. Yes, mining. Do mining, do spaceports, do something else first. Using money, and you want to build automated factories. Oh, you only have one industry on the whole planet. Yeah, kind of see your point. But please build it in one turn. Actually, you don't have to rush it. You don't have anything else to build. You really don't have anything else to build. Okay. What about this one? Deep extraction, automated factories. Guess you could. Special tree. Hypo farms. Yes. Good. Player defined 2. Player defined 3. It also works. Is the food focus, yeah. Please finish the bioharvest and add some soil improvements, please. Please. Not all those industries. Those are going to make me broke. Better do a government before do industry. Heschel. Wanna build automatic factories, don't you? How long will it take you? 2 turns, okay. Come on. Keep in mind there's two of those things to be built in this on this planet. You wanna mess with automated factories? I guess, but mess with them slowly. Mobilization center could be a factor in that corner of the universe. How long would it take you? Can you get it down? In 3 turns? 3 turns it's too much, but apparently, I can get it in 4 turns. I think we're going for it. Because I want, if we. Come on. If we look at it, a month is. It's not that far. But it is closer to this direction. It would save this this travel side. So if I find that I need to try to get hold of some food rich world around this area, it could be useful. Shipyards, not the shipyards, the planets. Planets is this okay. Amount. Heschel the first. You also want automated factories, huh? You suck. Probably a lot more tickling would be required to obtain the optimum. But yeah, time is of the essence. Research there. What is with this world? Player defined 3 on the thing. Desirable. Okay. This world is interesting. Shira. And that is a mobilization center that could really save travel distance. Arable surface. Okay, world. This world needs to produce food. Morla. I think this one's pretty far out of the way. So the mobilization center could be a thing. Or another first, and or another second, or another fourth. Never end in the sun. The sun is finally. Sometimes it lets you do that, sometimes you don't. You do have a ton of money from Empire. Use it to get the first industry. This world is pretty shitty. And I decided to mine some of it anyway in view of the incoming crisis. Yeah. That's basically it. Tauhida. Well, I don't think this one is watchable. Yeah, try to start with an industry, but then go for food. Anyway, at turn 51, we take another break. Research efficiency decreased. Zoom. Colony ship, RP, automated factory special. Colony ship, deep extraction colony ship. Ooh, lots of colony ships. Bioharvest, we're not dead yet. Ooh, but it rises so quickly. The need for food. It rises. Yes, this is the sort of numbers I like to see. Yes. At this. Wow, these guys can move people. I love it. Maybe it's because of the spaceports. They give them enough freighters to do the moving around. It could be the spaceports. That I'm dissing all the time, and perhaps this is one of the better functions, because here I know there's less population to move around, but still. Anyway, at turn 51, we take another break. See you guys next time.